Breaking: Trump delivers rude awakening to Obama holdovers, squashes, quote, the resistance by Adam Casalino, Politics U.S. News for MadWorldNews.com. As President Donald Trump works to make America great again, he faces many hurdles. Perhaps the hardest are the very people meant to work with him. Barack Obama loyalists are infested throughout government agencies. These employees consider themselves the resistance, quote, and are trying to undermine the White House. But they just got some bad news. Their days of ruining the United States are coming to an end. Recently, we learned about top FBI agents with anti-Trump bias. These people led major investigations that include Hillary's email scandal and the so-called Russia probe. Yet these agents were far from impartial. They were revealed to have serious conflicts of interest. Once discovered, they were booted off the cases. Some of them were demoted as far as you can go. However, they were only the tip of the iceberg. Obama planted numerous henchmen throughout the government. These people aren't interested in serving our country. They only wish to help liberals while making President Trump's job harder. But they won't be at it for much longer. One of the most notoriously liberal agencies, the EPA, just got some startling news. A firm was hired to root out the anti-Trumpers, and they have access to all of the staff's communications. The Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, hired a top consultant to investigate the agency's employees who criticized the Trump administration. Alan Bluestein, a vice president at the opposition research firm Definers Public Affairs, reportedly filed dozens of Freedom of Information Act FOIA requests with the agency over the past year to find dirt on agency employees who criticized the EPA or the Trump administration while on the clock, the New York Times revealed. I wondered if they were emailing critical things about the agency on government time and how frequently they were corresponding about this, Bluestein told the Times in an interview. And did they do anything that would be useful for Republicans? Bluestein added that he specifically looked into government employees who were members of the resistance, source Breitbart. You can't expect government employees not to have opinions, but when does a bias against President Trump become a major problem? When an employee trashes the president during office hours, that's a start. That suggests their bias is getting in the way of doing their job. An EPA employee can be liberal and still serve a Republican president. I should know, for 4 years, I worked as a contractor for the EPA from 2009 to 2013. I did my job even though I did not support Barack Obama. Liberals in the agency who let their bias undermine their jobs need to go. For them to actually work against the president is tantamount to criminal behavior. The request focused on agency employees like Michael Cox, who worked in the EPA's Seattle office and had sent a retirement notice in March to colleagues that raised questions about Mr. Pruitt's management, as well as agency employees who had participated in a public outreach program called Why Do You Love the EPA, which tried to build support for maintaining the agency's budget. Other employees who were the subject of such requests include Elizabeth Sutherland, who has been an outspoken critic of Mr. Pruitt since her recent retirement, Michael J. Mikulka, a Chicago-based union leader, and John O'Grady, the president of the American Federation of Government Employees, Council 238, source New York Times. The EPA is run by liberals. Environmentalists typically despise conservative politics and leaders. There is a good case to make that a staff is strongly opposed to President Trump. Is that bias getting in the way of their work? Most definitely. They might leak sensitive material to the press, or perhaps neglect to follow through on important projects, all to make the Trump White House look bad. We've already seen what happens when pro-Hillary FBI agents run cases. That kind of conflict of interest cannot exist in the government. Knowing what this firm is up to, EPA employees are on alert. They know they cannot get away with bashing the president while on the clock. If they use their agency time and resources to attack the president, they will get caught. It's a wake-up call for all anti-Trumpers in D.C. What do you think? Should people who hate the president work in the government? What should Trump do about these resistors? Be sure to leave a comment and let us know what you think. It makes a lot of sense. They're not working in favor for what Trump stands for and what the what America wants, actually. Also, let me know what you guys think. And again, thank you so much for watching.